السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1881 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today we focus on the 16th of Jumad al-Ukhra. It was on the 16th of Jumad al-Ukhra, 13 years after the Hijrah and migration to Medina Munawwara. It was corresponding to the 18th of August 634, the Battle of Marj al-Safar occurred between the Muslims and the Romans under the command of Sayyidina Khalid ibn Sa'id took place. This was the beginning of the Muslims' conquest of Asham. The battle ended in a victory for the Romans. It was due to this Amirul Mu'mineen, Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda, dispatched four armies for the conquest of Sham. And lo and behold, Sham refers to Syria, Palestine, Jordan, and Lebanon. So this is how they conquered. Then you see slowly, slowly, the whole of the Levant came under control of the Muslims. And the people who played great, great roles in this were Sir Khalid bin Walid radiallahu ta'ala an, Sayyidina Abu Ubaidah bin Jarrah radiallahu ta'ala an, Shurahbil bin Hasana radiallahu ta'ala an. And if you go to each one of these countries, alhamdulillah, we visited all four, that is Syria, Palestine, Jordan, and Lebanon, then you will find thousands of graves of Sahaba radiallahu an, and so many other awliyaullah and great, great scholars of Islam. And therefore, you will find even in the ending of Mishkat Sharif, there are ahadith regarding Sham and the manaqib and the virtues of Sham that are known as the merits and virtues. And one hadith comes to mind, إِذَا فَسَدَ أَهَلُ Sham, when there is fasad, fitna, turmoil, chaos in Sham, فَلَا خَيْرَ فِيكُمْ, then there is no goodness in you, meaning majority of the ummah, then we also have become an accomplice in this crime. And that is where we are today. Look at Syria, the Kuffar Shia of Bashar Assad and them in control. And you look at Palestine, the people, the rulers, they're selling out. And you look at Jordan, very similar also. And you look at Lebanon, there also they got Hezbollah, who are in reality Hezbollah Shaitan. So the whole of the Sham, Levant today is in corruption and mayhem and chaos. So remember, as Muslims, we must never become disillusioned, despondent in the mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. We see how the tide is turning. In America, we see how they're fighting with one another. In the rogue regime of Israel, occupied Palestine, the Jews are fighting one another. And we see that in Syria also the tide will turn. So everywhere, remember, فَإِنَّمَا الْأُسْرِ يُسْرَى إِنَّمَا الْأُسْرِ يُسْرَى, after difficulty there is ease. That is the system of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. But what we must remember is three things. We must ensure that we uphold the flag of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. We can never compromise or apologize for that. And we can never enter into unity with the Shias or with the Qadianis and all these deviant and people who are out of the fold of Islam. We need to be very, very clear on that. There is no unity with batil, with falsehood. So that is the law in Islam. Watawasaw bil haqq, watawasaw bil sabr. You always invite and exhort one another to the truth. Yes, there will be difficulties. Therefore, watawasaw bil sabr. And call and invite one another towards patience and endurance. So that is our message. Secondly, crying, begging, beseeching Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. We all believe from the inner recesses of our heart, the entire universe is under the sovereignty, authority, majesty of Almighty Allah alone. So Almighty Allah can grant us victory in a split second. And third one is this, make sure that all this filters down to our youth, our children, grandchildren, because today they're addicted to their cell phones and movies. The thought process is also gone come from their mind. May Almighty Allah grant us victory on all, in all places. Ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.